In chapter 14 of The Picture of Dorian Gray, Dorian sleeps so peacefully, his servant has trouble rousing him the next morning. The events of the previous night slowly seep back into his brain, along with his loathing for Basil. He decides that if he thinks too much about the event, he'll go crazy. So Dorian dresses carefully, reads his mail, and sends a message to Alan Campbell. While he waits for a response, Dorian reads poetry, losing himself in the beauty of the words and in the memories of travel they evoke. Eventually, Dorian begins to worry that Campbell is out of town. This leads to his reflecting on Campbell and their relationship. Campbell was a scientist with a strong interest in music who had gotten involved in the arts and society scene with Dorian. For 18 months, they were inseparable, the very best of friends. Then, they stopped associating with each other, and no outsider knew why. Campbell became morose afterward, lost interest in music, and took a greater interest in biology. Dorian becomes agitated waiting for Campbell to arrive, and when Campbell finally appears, it's obvious he doesn't want to be there. Oh. He views Dorian with contempt. Dorian tells him he needs his help to get rid of a dead body, and Campbell immediately refuses. Oh. Dorian tells him it was a suicide, and Campbell assumes Dorian drove the dead man to it. Then Dorian switches his story and admits it was murder. Campbell is horrified and still refuses to help. At last, Dorian writes something on a piece of paper and shows it to Campbell. When Campbell reads it, he becomes physically ill. Dorian follows this by saying he's written a letter that he will mail if Campbell doesn't help him. The implication is that the letter contains information that will ruin Campbell. Eventually, Campbell agrees to dispose of the body. He says he'll need to go fetch some supplies. Dorian refuses to let him leave and has Campbell write a list of supplies that his servant will fetch. After the servant delivers the supplies, Dorian then sends him on an additional errand to keep him out of the house while Campbell is doing his experiment, getting rid of the body. When Dorian and Campbell go upstairs, Dorian says he can't go in the room with the dead body again. Campbell goes in alone and works for hours to get rid of it. Eventually, he's done. As he leaves, he asks that the two of them never see each other again. While there is no overt homosexual activity in this novel, this is one of the chapters where it is very strongly implied. What did Dorian hold over Campbell to blackmail him into helping dispose of a body? There are also a few other things Wilde would have felt compelled to keep secret or only imply to the reader, as he does here by having Dorian pass a note to Campbell and by not allowing the reader to see what's written on it.